may be asking yourself, is personality even relevant to the study of why do people do what they do? Well, a lot of social psychologists ask that. I personally don't ask that question, but that's probably because I identify at least partially as a personality psychologist. So it would seem a little silly if I, as a personality psychologist, told you that personality didn't matter. Because it does. You've either already watched the Milgram Obedience to Authority video that preceded this, but it's also possible that you skipped ahead to this video because it's by me, not some random YouTube people. I encourage you to watch that video. It's going to be relevant. We'll be talking about that video in this video. So pause this guy and watch it if you haven't. Okay, cool. You've obviously watched it by now. So we'll keep going. And the reason why I bring up the Milgram experiment and those kind of classic, like, hardcore, these studies are why we have to have an IRB, is because they kind of push people to the extreme. And the thinking is that the situation dominates the entire, like, everyone, and that everyone follows the instructions. But, and I'm going to read you a couple of quotes describing these effects by Stanley Milgram and Philip Zimbardo. And that is on the next slide, please. Okay, let's try. Now. Yes! Okay. Sorry, it's the little tiny goals. So Stanley Milgram describes it as thus. The disposition a person brings to the experiment is probably less important a cause of his behavior than most readers assume. Often it is not so much the kind of person a man is as the kind of situation in which he finds himself that determines how he will act. Zimbardo speaks similarly. The obedience effect is due to the situational variables and not personality variables. These findings enable us to rule out the role of personality in obedient behavior. Now, if you just listen to these guys and not me, you would think, oh, it's all about the situation. People don't differ when they're put into those extreme kind of boundary conditions almost. Well, it turns out people still differ, even among these most extreme situations. So I'm going to talk mostly about the Milgram experiment, where people had to, where people had to essentially, men in all but one study, had to implement additional shocks higher and higher level. Now, across the Milgram studies, over the 740 subjects, which is quite a lot for psych, this is a series of psych studies, less than half implemented the highest dosage, 43.6% of them. And now on the next slide, I will illustrate this. Now 43% gave the highest shock, which means, thank you audience participation, that 56% didn't. And here is a nice illustration from a cool paper. It's a meta-analysis, or kind of a meta, they call it the meta-Milgram, which is cute, but not super informative. But what it did was it aggregated all the study results across all of Milgram's notes. And instead of just going to the raw papers, they went back into the Yale archives and got his actual notes and the tallies and aggregated them to examine what things seemed to impact individuals. And what were the sources of their differences? And as you can see in this giant weird diagram here that kind of looks like a stoplight where you had experimental conditions. This guy right here, I hope you can see my laser point. This guy. All right, well, we'll find out if you can see this. But where the experimenter conditions had some effect, including like the number of experimenters, so like the lab coat dudes, whether they were inconsistent, whether they seemed illegitimate, so did they seem like sketchy dudes in some basement just happened to be near Yale, or did they look like professors with sport coats or lab coats, as well as distance. And they looked at all those different effects, and on the next table, I've got a more detailed number breakdown, but here are how they kind of sliced up the different variables. Learner is the like research subject, or no, the learner is the guy that got shocked. Teacher is the person deciding to do the shock. And the quaintness of this study was that they had one group of women because they thought that would be fun. Not like representative, but as a novelty to see if they were more compliant or less compliant. But let's look at that data, because this figure kind of shows you how they break it down. And here, this table, I believe that these are the proportion of obedient participants as a function of their code value. And that code value is 1, they fully obeyed, and 0, they stopped before the maximum shock. And this value here is they obeyed, 0 is they didn't obey. This chi-square is a statistical metric to kind of quantify the difference in those effects, and the p-value is a way, and we'll talk about p-values in a bit, to describe how unusual it would be for those two groups to have come from the same population. Tiny p-values means that it's very unusual, and in psychology we kind of, the general rule is less than 5%, so we would expect something to be this unusual under 1 in 20 studies. Now for women, this sample here, women were more likely to obey, and it was significantly, the female group was significantly different from every other group. And in general, across all of these different kind of conditions and effects, and sorry, Archie is about to hit the camera. These individual differences explained about 30% of this. Now, I'm not 1,000% sure how the coding and the proportion is. I truly need to probably just email the researchers I've read. I have it in my show notes that I'm still not 100% confident in these interpretations. But I am confident in the 30%. So all of these kind of experimenter and teacher conditions only covered 30%, which means that the other, not explained by these variables. So there are still very big differences left to be explained, but my key takeaway, my key thing to emphasize here is that even under these most extreme conditions, people still differed. There were still differences to be explained. So I'm gonna wrap up this tiny little video here. And move on to the next one, and we'll talk more about actual personality paradigms and like what the hell I mean by personality. Up until now, it's kind of been preamble. We're gonna actually talk to you about the class now. See you in a bit.